We're gonna cover the topic of whether or not Jordan Burroughs is the greatest American wrestler of all time, and we're gonna start right now. So recently, Jordan Burroughs went out in 2021, went to Oslo, Norway, weighing in the 79 kilo weight class and just totally dominated. Walked through every single opponent looking like the Jordan Burroughs of old, looking like the Jordan Burroughs of the comeback year in 2017, and just went out and decimated everybody. Yes, he was banged up a little bit here and there, but one of the things that he said after winning that world title in 2021 in Oslo was that,
"I'm certified, I'm a legend in this sport, and no one can take that away from me."
He absolutely 100% is a legend. And it started to trigger that thought process. For me, as a layperson that does enjoy freestyle wrestling, the international style of wrestling, I started to sit there and think, is he the best American ever? And you start to think, well, what can we do to measure who is the greatest of all time? Who is the greatest American freestyle wrestler of all time? Directly looking at medals, I like to look at international world championship medals. So world championships, Olympic Games, and counting them essentially equal. Obviously, Olympics, I'm gonna count a little bit more favorable, but going into those world championships, and then also looking at the continental championships, so Pan Am champs or Pan Am games. And I also think that there's got to be a little bit of an influence too, not only on how many medals, who their opponents were, but also their direct impact on the sport. How do they change the sport? That's what makes a legend, and that's also if that makes you one of the greatest of all time. And so as I started to compile this and go through all the different processes of, all right, I wanna make my own personal ranking of who are the top three freestyle wrestlers ever from the United States, I immediately knew who would be in those top three outside of Burroughs. Now Burroughs, if you think about, he graduated from college in 2011, wins a world title in 2011, and then comes out in 2012 and wins the Olympics and beats Dennis Targush, who's one of the best at that time, and then just goes on this steamroll train, right? And all the way through, I think 2014, he was even banged up, injured, hurt his knee, and won the world bronze, and then goes in, wins a world title again, goes in 2016, loses in the first round, gets out of the Olympics in the first round. We all think he's done, we all think his career's over. But what's he do? Comes back 2017, wins a world title in 2017. 2021 comes around and everybody thinks he's on his way out. He goes to the Olympic trials, loses to Kyle Dake at the Olympic trials. And he actually posted something on Instagram, like, hey, you know what, I'm gonna make a run for the world championship at 79 kilos and I'm gonna win the world title. And that's exactly what he did. So that's a real brief synopsis of his career and what he did. But who can we compare him to now? He's won that Olympic championship. He has 5 gold medals at the world championships. He is 3 bronze medals at the world championship. So he has 8 world championship medals. He has that Olympic title. You get the Pan Am Games and you get the Pan Am Champs. And in the games, he has 3 gold medals and he has 4 Pan Am Championship medals. So now we're taking that step back even further and we're going, there's longevity to the career as well. So he's active from 2011, basically internationally, all the way till at minimum 2021 right now. He's got 13 gold medals and 3 bronze medals. He's looking at 16 total international medals over a span of at least a decade. And I think what's gonna happen is gonna be really interesting now as we go into comparing that to 2 other key wrestlers. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little comparison here where we look at John Smith and Bruce Baumgartner. And now we can sit there and we can dive in. Okay, how many medals did each of these guys have? John Smith has a shorter international career. He's basically active from 87 to 92. Meanwhile, Baumgartner's going from like 81, 82, all the way to 96. So what, 14, 15 years about wrestling at that elite level? Now he took some years off where he was focusing on his job and stuff like that, but he still was active essentially for a very long period of time. Now we get into the Olympics. They each have 2 gold medals. Now here's one thing, and I remember Bruce Baumgartner talking about this. He won the 84 Olympics and there was no Soviets there. So one of his Olympic golds in his mind was tainted, which is sort of crazy, but it's tainted by his accord. So in 88, he's a silver medalist. He wanted to win an Olympic title with the Russians there. So he goes into 92. Wins a gold medal in 92. So he's got 84 and 92 as his golds. He's got a silver in 88. He comes back even in 96. I remember him telling the story. I called up Jeff Blatnick. I said, we're going at it again. We're gonna try and bring something home in 96. And he wins the bronze. Now compare that to John Smith, who goes into Seoul and wins in Seoul. I think he beats Stepan Sarkisian in Seoul. And then in 92, he goes out and he beats Mohamedian in 92. So now he's got those two golds to sort of battle with Bruce Baumgartner, but he doesn't have those other two medals at the Olympics. And now we go into those world championships with both these guys. Baumgartner, 3 world titles, 3 world silver medals, 3 bronzes. Okay, so he has 9 total world medals. That's compared to 8 with Jordan Burroughs. Now compare this with John Smith. He's got 4 world gold titles. Okay, so 4 of those, two of the Olympic titles. We've got 3 for Baumgartner at the world championships and 2 Olympics. So that's 5 total international titles. Try to remember back now with Smith, he's got 6 international titles. We know John Smith has 6 world titles. We know that Jordan Burroughs has 6 international titles. We know that Baumgartner has 5. Now we go down into the Pan American Games and the Pan American Championships. Now remember, Pan American Games is only happening every 4 years. Pan American Championships happens every single year. So the longer you're in the sport, the more opportunity you have for the games. And that's where still, John Smith, 2 Pan Am Games gold medals. Now looking at Baumgartner, he's had 3 Pan Am Game gold medals and then 1 silver medal. He also won the Pan American Championships 3 different times. So what does this bring together? We know that essentially Burroughs and Smith are tied with the international titles, right? They each have 6, which is just mind blowing, right? Burroughs has won the world title 5 times and he's won the Olympics once. Then we look at the continental titles. Burroughs has the edge by 1 over Bruce Baumgartner. It's 7-6 total titles there. And then meanwhile, you know, John Smith only has 2 because his international career was much shorter. So I think to actually come to a conclusion here, it's a little tough because now we got to think about, is there impact on the sport as a wrestler? Baumgartner's had his heavyweight camp, right? He impacted guys like Matt Gaffari. And I think that he even had a really big impact on Rulon Gardner and all those guys. Baumgartner even had an impact on Stephen Neal. So that's like that realm of heavyweights in the late 90s, early 2000s that really started to change how heavyweight was being wrestled at that international level. And I think that all of those Olympic medals had a big impact. Now, same with John Smith. I think John Smith completely changed the sport. It went from the Stone Age to that bridge period leading into what we have now, where it's super high intense, lots of scrambles, lots of crazy action. And I think John Smith was essentially at the forefront for that. His technique, his style, his aggressiveness is what really changed that sport, the sport, into being more entertaining. But I believe Jordan Burroughs' style of wrestling has actually saved the sport. I think somebody like Jordan Burroughs is actually partially responsible for the sport not being taken out of the Olympics. And that's a big, bold statement. But I also believe his character, his charisma, and his ability on the mat, and his ability to even handle major losses to someone like Kyle Dake, and major setbacks that he's had at the world level, at the Olympics, even in 2016, the way he handled that loss, it was, you know, he's a class act. And I think that when it comes down to it, all 3 of these guys are absolutely phenomenal. I would say, you know, it's tough because of the number of Olympic golds and the number of Olympic medals from Bruce Baumgartner, but from the total world titles, I would start to put Burroughs probably at number 1.5 or 2, and probably have Baumgartner up there as well, and then move John Smith down to 3. Not taking anything away from these guys. You know, this is just a really fun discussion to have, but thinking about if Burroughs continues, if he continues through, you know, he's moved to Pennsylvania here, he's training at the Penn RTC. If he continues moving forward and goes to 2024, it's gonna be interesting, because I think if he continues to 2024 and he can make a push and possibly make that team, we don't know what's gonna happen. He's getting older, he's 33, so he's got what, three years left. If he can make that team, and if he can win 1 more world gold, I believe he will go down as the greatest American wrestler of all time. He is 100% a legend. And if you look at these top 3 guys, Bruce Baumgartner, John Smith, and Jordan Burroughs, deciding who the number 1 guy is, I think is almost impossible. Right now, I've got a little bit of an edge towards Baumgartner and his impact on that heavyweight division, and how it just sort of created this snowball effect into the late 90s with Stephen Neal, with, you know, even Matt Gaffari as a Greco guy, how that led to the development of guys like Nick Gwizdowski, who we train here at Garage Strength, and then how that impacted Gable Stevenson and all these guys. So I think it's really tough, because at the same time, I think Jordan Burroughs was impacted by John Smith, and I think Burroughs has probably had the biggest reach and the biggest positive impact on the sport out of anybody, out of all three of these guys. I do believe that because of Burroughs' presence, his charisma, and his impact on social media even, I believe Jordan Burroughs has probably impacted more than all these guys. If Burroughs goes to 24, I believe he's gonna become the greatest American freestyle wrestler of all time, no questions asked. In the meantime, all three of these guys are legends. I hope you guys enjoy this. Discuss your rankings down in the comments down below and who you think is the number one American freestyle wrestler of all time. If you want more content around wrestling, click on this card right here. Until next time, guys, peace.